What? will forgive you. Did you do anything? Did you commit anything? Of course not. When I said I live for you, did you think I was exaggerating?
So you mean you forgive me?
Oh, why not? What would I mean, there's nothing to forgive. Like, did you commit anything? There's nothing to forgive.
Well, thank you, Umpire. You're such a darling.
It's a general idea. Everybody says that. To the kitchen and prepare yourself.
I don't know how to cook.
You start one day.
Who will teach me?
It's me around, you don't need another teacher, Johnny.
Me know how to cook?
That's an understatement. I once worked as a cook for a white couple.
White couple?
Yes.
So what happened?
No worry. What do you want me to prepare for you?
I will eat fried plantain.
Fried plantain with beans or just fried
plantain? No, not beans.
Fried plantain.
Fried plantain with fried egg. With egg, yeah.
You and egg. The one I have is yes,
It's very well.
Thank you. Ako? Is that your new name for me?
Don't like it?
No, it's okay. Just that. I'll be very glad to be your uncle. Don't you like it?
I do. This is delicious.
No worries, please. Johnny.
Yes.
We are going to step up the art.
Step up?
Yes. You know where criminals get caught?
When they get careless?
No. Because they are greedy.
Then my mom told me that greed breeds carelessness.
Johnny. Criminals get greedy because they refuse to step out from their routine.
What do you mean?
For instance, if a car thief decides to open up a car dealer shop, that way he will gradually quit from car snatching before he gets caught.
Are you criminals, Uncle?
Johnny, what an awkward question.
My mother told me that crime is bad.
What did she tell about stealing?
We haven't got to that before I left home.
Thank you, count yourself lucky then. But before then, Johnny, we are talking about stepping up.
Yes.
Johnny, we need to open a phone shop. That way we sell directly to consumers.
A phone shop? Sell directly to consumers?
Not only that, we stop Ben from bleeding us white.
What if the person who stole the phone comes to buy it?
Johnny, there's no way. Because he can't prove his ownership. Besides, that's the more reason why we have to step up.
But Uncle, let me ask you something. Ain't you the one trying to be greedy?
Johnny, smart boy. I can see that you're feeling sleepy. You know what? You go and sleep. Tomorrow I'll continue from where I stop. Maybe I'll give you the full details tomorrow, okay?
Alright, Uncle.
You can sleep.
Alright,
Johnny, go and sleep, okay?
About your phone.
You cannot see us. Better
you. Did I look like a thief? I'll beat you. Are you mad?
Come on, don't
come on, leave me.
Get my phone. What do you mean? Get my phone, John.
I'm scared.
That's the joke of the century, Johnny.
It's not a joke again, Uncle.
No, Johnny. I mean, how can little Johnny of all people be scared?
No, for what? Don't almost caught me today.
Johnny, you have to be very, very careful because we can't afford to screw up now.
Uncle, I'm not operating for 1 week. Just want to have a break.
Johnny. Okay. Need a break. Don't worry, I'll give you maybe 1 week. 1 week break. So that you rest.
Alright, thank you, okay.
Johnny.
Thank you. Let me go inside and have my
break. Alright, Johnny. This is sweet. Johnny. This is for maybe 60 grams. 40, sharp like 30,000. It's for me to do. Hello?
Hello?
Who is this?
Thief, I am the owner of the phone you just stole from me now.
Oh, that was before. Now I'm the owner.
Please, I want that phone back right now. Please.
You mean the phone or the SIM card?
Both of them. But you see, I think the phone is more important because it's very expensive.
Oh, how much did you buy the phone?
I bought it for 120,000 naira.
120,000? Jesus! Do you know that you are very stupid? You are wicked! So, you spent 120,000 naira on phone? What? There are people roaming the street. People that don't have anywhere to sleep. People that have not eaten for the past 1 week. You're not a true Nigerian.
That's not important right now. Please, I just need to get that phone back right now. Please.
Oh, God, don't do this to me. Okay, let's strike it through. I'll pay.
Whatever amount, just tell me what you want. I'll send you the money, whatever. So far, I get the phone back, please.
Don't worry, I'm sorry. I have my customers already.
I'm willing to pay any amount, provided I get the phone back.
Don't Oh! God has already blessed me. As you can see, he made it possible for me to steal this phone from you.
Please. Oh, good. I don't know what else to do. Please.
Where can I get the phone? Please. I need to get this phone back. Don't do this to me now.
You know what? This is business hour. The only thing you can do for me now is to send me the charge card for 1,503 so that you can be communicating. Maybe sometimes if you call, or just flash me, I'll give you the call. Flash me, I'll call you back. I don't mind though. Whether you can flash me from business center, I'm ready to call back. This is business.
Charge card.
No, don't just embarrass me. Thank you for calling. Yeah, thank you. God bless you.
Not anymore.
Okay. I am Lazarus. Look at me. I am Lazarus. Back to life again.
Maybe in your own world. Well, not mine.
Look into my eyes. And what do you see? Just tell me, what do you see?
Do you really want me to tell you what I see?
Yes.
I see a helpless man. I see a man that lacks guts and will. An utterly confused man. And that is not the picture of the man I married 10 years ago.
Esther, you got it all wrong, but one. Yes, the man you married 10 years ago.
Not anymore.
Esther, please, just do me a favor. I take all the way from Gregory to this place. Esther, please, I need a clean bath. Please, shave a stick and 2 bottles of drink, you know, my usual. To step down, please. I am just tired. I can't just come now and start quarreling with you. Esther, do. Just look at me. Look at me. Where are we, Esther? Esther, she follow this right.
Wait.
Esther, come now. I see my good lady. See you here. Leisure? Yes, leisure. All of us are no play, make Jack a dull ball.
Oh, come on. What kind of play do you want us to play again? We do play every time. Let's go home and play game.
John, I want to tell you something.
Yes.
Woman? Yes. You see, after creating what was a perfect world, God suddenly dreamed of a woman and gave Adam and Eve a righteous man never requested for. Ever since, man and God has never rested.
Is it true?
Believe every inch of my word. See, well, you're too young to understand. Try to remember this as you grow up. No woman ever rush a man without something in return at the back of her mind.
I understand. I don't know what you're talking about.
Yes, you need to understand. But as you grow up, you will encounter the word love. It exists only for the man. Johnny?
maybe less protection. And what she suspects, he can provide it for her. She gives it her love. But once it blows up on her face, she jumps into another train.
Another train?
Yes, another train. Well, it's a phrase. You understand? But you are smart enough to understand what I'm talking about. For better, for worse, it's for men. We are only suckers. Even the priest will say it. Believe it. You know why?
Why, uncle?
Because the marriage priest can never be a woman. For better, for worse, when the priest said that, the woman, in her reply, says in her mind, for better, we'll stay. For less, you're on your own. Isn't that funny? Huh, Johnny?
I don't know.
What about my son? Be it a boy or a girl, our piggy.
There's no baby.
What? Did he die? What happened? Accident or what? What happened?
Immediately after your sentencing, I had a miscarriage.
God! So there's no baby to welcome you home!
How dare you? Do you know what I went through? All that time you were in prison? Do you know what I went through during that miscarriage? Did you even bother about me? In fact, you know what? Just get out. Just get out. I don't even want you here. Just leave. I don't want my mother to meet you here.
Excuse me. You just passed the night for today.
Eh? That's what. You said what?
Mm-hmm. Pass what? Passed the night today.
N-O. Read my lips. No! Oh yeah? No. Outside.
Excuse me.
Alele!
Esther! Please! Why are you behaving like this?
Why would I behave like that? You're asking for your baby. I don't even want to be Esther. Outside! This is not true. I beg, get out! Leave my house!
Esther, please.
When my mother comes back.
I have no place to go.
Eh. Why don't you go back to Kirikiri?
Esther, please, I still love you.
Ah! Make her hear what?
Esther, please, I promise I will make up for the lost years.
Get out!
Nonsense. Why did you do this to me?
Do you want me to shout?
Oh, no.
I'll shout, too.
Esther, please.
I'll shout, too.
Please, Esther.
I'll shout.
Don't!
Oh, no!
It's okay, please.
Ole! Ole! Stupid man. Petty thief. I'm robber.
Johnny, you're a smart boy. You come to even know more than I do. But meanwhile, I'm bringing home tonight someone.
Woman?
Smart boy, Johnny. Johnny, you're a smart boy. Oh, don't worry. You need more Fanta, I'll get you one.
I'm okay.
Can I get me more cigarettes, please? Just one more. So, Johnny.
Just settled and here we are. Honey, make yourself comfortable.
Nice to meet you, Johnny. How are you?
Fine, Esther.
Johnny is my little nephew. Johnny, I'm your uncle, right?
Sure.
Okay. And my wife is your auntie, right?
I guess so.
I guess so. Okay, that's good. Is it Johnny? Maybe you will go inside and watch the television, okay? Let me come back and take this back.
Hey, how you manage now? This place is so beautiful.
My God, oh. My God.
Not be small.
Thank God.
Now, wow.
So, what do I order for you? I have wine, spirit, juice, bobo tibo.
You know what? Make I drink wine now. Make I follow you now. I did not say that we should drink wine now.
Let me take it. Those cerebrals.
Pee-pee!
That's my house.
Pee for piles.
That's me.
Hey. Yeah. So, let's start.
John, I know you must have been surprised last night.
Yeah, you can say that again. One time you told me you don't need them, then that's why you brought them.
Yes, I know.
So why did you bring her?
Yeah, to serve her purpose.
Isn't she gonna complicate things?
No, she won't. She's going to run the shop.
Oh, you mean to manage the sales?
Exactly.
Is she gonna be trusted?
Well, with me piloting affairs, she would do.
Alright, if you say so.
Johnny. I know you don't like the idea of calling her auntie, but you know what? It is just to fool her. We need to make her believe that you are my real nephew. That way, she won't be difficult.
Why would she be difficult?
Those are the things I told you about women.
No problem. I want to go hunting today.
You wanna go hunting tonight?
Yeah, sure.
That's great news, Johnny. That's nice. Johnny, okay, you know what? You go and tidy up while I do so. I'll go with you tonight. Johnny, go to your room.
My son, no. Johnny, my best friend. Johnny, my bikini, no. Johnny, I no send, no. Anybody but Johnny, cause Johnny.
Johnny. Yeah, Johnny. I'm back.
Okay.
Yes. Let me see. It's time to fortify myself.
Fortify yourself?
Yes. You won't understand. But I think I need this to satisfy my conscience.
How?
Johnny, this is for me and me alone. Johnny, you see, I don't want to leave Trigger happy. I don't want to continue like that. But you know what? In your mind, you'll be thinking, how did I set out to become a criminal? But I'll explain to you later. Let me keep this sense. I'm coming. Johnny.
My son, no. Johnny, my best friend. Johnny. My bikini, no. Johnny. I no send, no. Anybody but Johnny.
At the back of his pocket.
Did you see his white skin? Did you? Or do you think he can just steal any person's thing and go scot free?
I'm sorry, I won't do it again.
Come, if I hold your ear. Never you, never ever, don't ever see. device at the pocket or even the asset.
Amen.
Don't ever do that.
Amen.
Have you heard me?
Amen. I won't do that again.
Don't try that.
All right.
Have you learned your lesson?
Yes, I've learned my lessons. Have you forgiven me?
Yes.
All right. I'm sorry.
It's okay.
Have you forgiven me?
Yes, I have. It's okay. Go and take your bath, okay? Please.
Sue, you are so upset with your son of yours. You fail to understand the danger rolling by.
What danger?
You know Johnny is with a bad company.
So what?
He will not hesitate to put a gun on me.
Come on, Johnny is yet to be 10, let alone know the meaning of a gun.
Sue, nothing can stop Johnny from putting a bullet in me. So I will not give him a chance.
For our own child, have our own children.
Where have you been for the past 9 years? If it wasn't that you went to jail, we would have had over half a dozen children by now.
That is true. But I'm very, very, very sorry. I'm just sorry. You see, we need children.
Well, you were skeptical about having children before.
I know. When you see, whenever I see this little Johnny run around there, I mean, in the house, I feel a desperate need to have my own child.
Okay. If we're going to have children, you have to promise me that you will keep away from any criminal activities. Because I don't want to be pregnant again and then police will come and arrest you again.
Honey, I promise. I promise. Nothing like that will ever happen again. It's this promise from my heart. I cross it. Nothing like that will ever happen again.
Well, let's just hope I can still have children.
No, you will.
You know it's been a long time.
No. Just believe God.
Yes. Did you believe what I told you when you came out of prison? Did you think I meant it though?
Did you?
Of course not.
Why did you push me?
Well, I was only testing your love, you see. Look at your body, everything is still intact. This part almost 10 years of our separation. But you remember now, I was only 20 when we got married.
Even at that, your body is still as succulent as a fresh apple.
Oh, Pius, make me laugh. honey.
What is that? What is that?
That's your nephew.
You mean Johnny?
Oh, yes, Johnny. Can't he just go somewhere else?
Go where?
I don't know. Village or anywhere.
What?
You know now, this is like our first real honeymoon.
So?
Okay, what if now I just want to walk into the house and walk around naked?
walk around naked.
Mm-hmm. My friend Agatha, that's how she has it with her husband. Once she just walks into the house, they lock the door, they just take off their clothes and us fire each other, you know. Wouldn't you like that?
Yeah? Okay. What will happen to little Johnny?
You can go anywhere. Yeah. To the village or many. Don't you have any other relatives you can stay with?
No. No.
Why?
Because one, we've come a long way. Two, he has no place to go.
So what? You've come a long way. What does that mean?
See, that one knows all my customers. He does most of the purchases. I mean, you see, I can't just go without that boy.
Okay, what about me? Why don't you introduce me to the customers?
No, mommy. Your job there is to take care of the shop. I mean, sell the phones. What else? In fact, let's just forget about it. Let's change the topic.
No. That boy must go. Honey, he must go. Ah. Don't be me and that boy.
I was telling you that somebody hurt me very badly.
The man that sent you to jail?
Well, if you put it that way.
So what happened?
Johnny, for all the wrong reasons, I was dumped in jail. I was used and dumped into incarceration for 9 good years.
9 good years?
Yes, 9 good years. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 good years.
Jesus Christ.
Johnny, I never was a criminal. I never stole anything. But for something I knew nothing about, I got cast away for 9 important years.
Some people can be really mean, Uncle.
Johnny, you can say that again.
So where is this man now?
Still around.
So where? Where is he?
You see, Johnny, going to prison changes a lot of things. One, you are home with a tag ex-convict that nobody wishes to touch you. While in the cell or while in prison, you are mixed with the real criminals, Johnny.
You mean it?
Johnny, when you walk out from Nigerian cell, your life changes. It becomes worse than when you entered. If you had entered as petty thief, Johnny, you are coming out as a real criminal, an armed robber. If you had entered as an innocent man on the wrong charge, you are coming out with a mixture of both.
I want to do.
I once told my friend, my inmate, my audio, and he advised that vengeance. Yes, but I should live. On vengeance, Johnny. Vengeance. Did for that. As put up by the great prophet himself, Moses. Johnny.
I'm getting interested.
Don't worry. I'll get you involved when it's time.
All right.
I'll always get you along with me. Johnny, you know one thing, I love you. You're too smart. You like this?
Yeah. I don't want this.
Johnny.
You want juice?
I'm quitting this country by the end of this month.
I'm not going without Johnny.
I'm leaving this country without you.
We go when I go.
But you just said you're not leaving the country.
I just said that I'm not going without Johnny.
Yes? And how should we let you go with me? What is you?
You?
Yes, me. You thought I would rot in jail. Oh, come on. 9 years is not 9 decades. As you can see, I survived. Here I am.
Pius?
Yes, that's me. The loyal servant. The efferent group you got slammed up in jail.
Nobody set you up. You rogue?
Oh, come on. We're not in the witness box, and there's no jury around. Besides, I've served my jail term. So, save that returning for great movies. You guys set me up.
What do you want now?
What? Since you people were stupid enough to steal aside in the country, I've come to collect my
Collect what?
My fee.
What fee?
Look, your wife dear practically raped me of the son you couldn't give her. And instead of you rewarding me for what I did for you, you purposefully sent me up and brought me to jail. Just for beat. But then it was me enough to just obey the common law of emotion.
You must be nuts.
Ah, well, let me tell you, I'm not here for any naughty issue. I've come here to collect my money. And if you're not quick at doing that, I'll blow the secret wide open.
What secret?
You don't know? Now people will be interested to know how a white woman married to a white man should give birth to a black boy. Tell them that I am the father.
Enough.
You have no proof.
Ah, is that what you think? Okay, remember, I have the doctors, the nurses, and even the boy to attest to my claim.
You don't understand what I'm talking now.
You don't know what I'm talking about? Okay. You know what? $100,000, I will let the sleeping dogs laugh.
What? $100,000?
Yes.
Over my dead body.
Ah! Okay. You know, this is what I like doing best. It impresses me, it gives me happiness. But I'm not in a hurry to lose this. I think I love the $100,000 more. But if you try to cheat me, I'll end it all. I'll be forced to lose this. Besides, I've got nothing to lose. It is you that have a lot to lose. When I put you behind bars, you know what I mean. So, go. I'm giving you people less than 59 seconds to deliberate on that. Best! You fuck your hands. Bastard door. So!
You to stop calling me Esther.
Is it not your name?
Yes, but you didn't give me that name. I'm not gonna take this from you, you insolent little brat.
Stop disturbing your blood pressure and listen to what I have to say.
Hey, I don't die. Oh, yeah, yeah. Get out of here, John.
Esther, why are you behaving like this?
Look at this boy. What's the matter with you? Eh? I told you to stop calling me Esther.
So what do I call you?
I am auntie to you. Is that clear?
Alright. Does uncle call you auntie?
Duh. Your uncle is my husband.
Alright. Then what about Mike? Does he call you auntie?
Eh? Where did you hear that name
does
from?
Does he call you auntie?
How do you know Mike?
Answer my question. Does Mike call you auntie?
Where did you hear that name from?
Esther, never mind. The walls have ears.
So you follow me around now or what?
That's not the point. The point is that Uncle will be very interested in knowing what you do with Mike.
John. Please, don't tell your uncle about Mike, please. You hear?
I won't. She completely dropped wanting me to quit from the house.
How did you know that?
I'm a busy person.
Chinooke. Which kind of game be this?